Hello, everybody. It's Eddie Funkster. So check it out. I've been digging through some things, cleaning up my stuff in my room, and ran across Big Book of Buds for Red Rosenthal. So this was like published in, I don't know, let me see, 2010 from Ed Rosenthal's Quick Trading Publications. So he put me in this book. It was pretty cool. He's a good friend of mine. Smoked a lot of good herb with Ed. Great mentor. Saw me with a lot of things in life when it comes to cannabis things and personal efforts. So one of the strains I made and put in here was Diabolic Funksta, which was a sour diesel OG Kush cross I did. Yep, East Coast sour diesel cross with Funksta's triple OG Kush. Yeah, this is one of my males I've made a lot of cool things with. So I actually wanted to do this video because of this one right here. This was a strain I was really known about. It's Funksta's Purple Cali Kush. It's a purple strain I made. Jeez, this is like in 2008, 2010, so he wanted me to write an article about what I do and why I do it. So I used to take these books all over the place with me when I did shows and stuff. Talk to patients about things. So this is what I wrote. He said, hey, write something so I could put it in the book about what this Funksta name is and why you do what you do. So I put it's called The Story of Funksta's Purple Cali Kush, The Funksta. Back then my company was called Don't Panic Organics. So a little tidbit who I used to be back in the day. It was like 2008, 2005 to like 2012 or something. So my varieties include the name Funksta because in my Southern California home, I am known by this nickname. And a connection with the genetic work for a cannabis collective I work with. I am passionate about creating high quality organic cannabis and helping the many patients who benefit from its effects. I discovered that breeding was very personal satisfying for me. In the beginning, I wanted to see if I can create a stable strain of high quality cannabis. I never expected to witness the diversity of the cannabis genius that I have seen. To this day, I am still blown away by the varieties that are possible and strongly alive. I want to bring forth new world techniques with brand new hybrids, and I always hope to find that special genotype that gives back something to the community of cannabis patients and cannabis fans who have guarded the survival of this plant and its amazing healing properties. In my opinion, Funksta's Purple Cali Kush has something special to offer. Kush origins are often a source of confusion. This variety comes from the Chem Diesel lines in California, not the Landrace Hindu Master Kush lines, more common to the European strains. The purple comes from the Granddaddy Purple strain, giving a strong coloration at harvest and influencing the flavor, which to me is the essence of purple. That weed was delicious. Let's see. This strain was developed because patients were interested in rejuvenating a beloved Granddaddy Purple mother plant that was aging. As a result, the clones were giving suboptimal yields. I was already developing seeds from an inbreed line of OG Kush for myself, and in that breeding work, I discovered a male that produced amazing progeny. Crossing this male with Granddaddy Purple mother restored the quality, vigor, and yield to a highly desirable plant. Since my first attempts at breeding, I have learned so much about the plant kingdom and cannabis. I've also learned so much from them. My advice for any budding grower and breeders out there is to study, learn, teach, don't discriminate, and go out of your comfort zone. Feed your mind with knowledge and learn from the unknowing. I couldn't call myself a cannabis breeder if I only worked on one variety in life. Cannabis should be a source of generosity, never a source of greed. I started this endeavor for my own joy in the process. But now, my joy comes from being able to produce varieties that others need and want. I'm humbled by this plant and also glad that my work allows me to be a force for good in the lives of many patients. It's crazy, I wrote that in like 2008, 2009. We published this in 2010. It's really cool to be part of publishing some old publications for the work that this was like so important to me. For a very big time in my life, still is today too. I mean, I work with a lot of people daily with cannabis, teaching them, showing them, growing with them, smoking with them. So You know, just wanted to take a moment, just give thanks to Ed Rosenthal, his books he's put me in, all the publications, movies, interviews. Jeez, man, it's been a beautiful life with the ganja. So I just want to give thanks. Hope everybody does well. Have a beautiful life. Give thanks.